Ladies and gentlemen, we are back.
We bike.
Last time we talked, man, we was waiting for this album. It's finally here.
Yeah, it is here, and I'm loving it.
Yes, sir.
Come from a generation of home invasions, and I got daddy issues, that's on me. Everything them four walls that taught me, may have is buried deep. That man knew a lot, but not enough to keep me past them streets. My life is a plot, twisted from directions that I can't see. Daddy issues all across my head, told me fuck a foul, I'm teary-eyed. Wanna throw my hands, I won't think out loud, a foolish pride. If I lose again, won't go in the house, I stayed outside. Laughing with my friends, they don't know my life. Daddy issues made me learn losses, I don't take those well. Mama said that boy is exhausted, he said go fuck yourself. If he give up now, that's gonna cost him. Life's a bitch, you could be a bitch or step out the margin. I got up quick, I'm charging baskets and falling back, but trying to keep balance. Oh, this the part where mental stability meets talent. Oh, this the part he breaks my humility just for practice. Tactics we learn together, so it loses forever. Daddy issues.
Early morning wake ups, practicing on things.
Mr. Morale.
Your father should detox my calling, it's right on time. Transformation, I must have 1,000 lives and like 3,000 wives. You should know that I'm slightly off fighting off demons that been outside. Better known as myself, I'm a demigod. Every thought is creative, sometimes I'm afraid of my open mind.
Shit on my mind and it's heavy. Tear you in pieces cause it's way too heavy. My diamonds, the joker is heavy. More life to give on the men, are you ready? Who keep them honest like us? Who in alignment like us? Who gotta heal them or us? Us, when there's no one to call.
Yes, yeah.
I pop the pain away, I slide the pain away. I pop the pain away, I slide the pain away.
First impressions, when you first put on the album, what did you think?
I was thinking, well, I'm glad it's a rainy day because this is a fucking gloomy ass fucking tone album, really. But yes. I was in the right state of mind for it,
right?
Fortunately, but yeah, I was like, damn, this tone is really, really serious, and he's about to talk about some real shit.
I was thinking, man, like, I was like, damn. Like, just from the heart part five, you kind of knew the direction he was going in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I put on the album. I was listening to what he was saying. Beats, wasn't listening to the beats at all. I was just listening to what he was saying.
Yeah.
I was like, wow, this is heavy.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Very heavy.
Yeah, very.
But then I listened to it on my way to work. Like, almost was able to listen to the whole entire album on my way to work.
Yeah.
Got out the car, went in, and was like, damn, this shit is crazy. And I digested song by song and thought about it, and I was like, wow. But then, when I got in the car to go home, after I digested the point he was trying to get across, and I listened to the music, and it sounded totally different. It was like, I'm not going to lie to you. I listened to that album at least 10 times.
Okay.
And it sounded different each time.
Yeah.
It sounded different each time. And it's like, the things that he was talking about was real heavy, right? And you caught some shit. But then, the second time, the third time, it's like you catch something different every single time.
Yeah, man.
Really. Great album. I don't think that the world that we live in, the climate that we live in right now, we live in like a quick microwavable situation where you just quick, I want the hits.
Yeah.
I don't want to digest it. I'm not going to go back to it.
Yeah, not give it a chance.
This is an album that you can go back to.
Yeah.
I've heard a lot of shit. I woke up super early in the morning and I was reading some of the reviews. Mm-hmm. 90% of them were negative.
Oh, really? I haven't seen any reviews, honestly.
A lot of them were negative.
Mm, okay.
One thing that stuck out to me was one of the guys, he said, damn, what the fuck is wrong with this nigga? He recorded this album on Sherm. A lot of other people were just like, this ain't it. I want Damn. I want Good Kid, Mad City.
Yeah. I think a lot of those people probably didn't give it another playthrough. They probably give it that first playthrough. Because, I mean, I could kind of understand that. Like, that first playthrough, I was like, man, this shit is serious. Like, I hear what he's saying. It's real shit.
But it's heavy.
I don't know if I really want to play this shit again. But then I played it again. I was like, okay. Okay. Yeah. I'm fucking with it more and more. Every time I played it, it was like, I can really, like, fuck with it harder and harder.
And he got some bops on his journey, too. Does. It's like, that first time, you really didn't hear the bops. You were just so focused on what he was saying.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it's easy to digest, because even with the bops, he's saying some real shit.
Yeah.
But
you really got to give it a serious... If you're going to listen to it one time, it probably won't be something that you want to go back to. Because it's a lot of shit there that you probably will miss. And the overall tone of it isn't really one of those like, yeah, man, I'm gonna play this shit in the summer. It's the summer fucking anthems and shit. It's nothing like that on there. It's real serious.
Exactly. I was at work yesterday and I talked to one of my coworkers. And she told me the Kendrick Lamar album is ass.
Mm. Okay.
I said, why do you feel like that? She said, I'm not with that jazzy, like, poetry, artsy type shit. Give me, you know, his other albums. Mm. My guy friend said that his other albums, he's never been like this before.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't agree.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
Kendrick have always been like this, from Overly Dedicated to Section 80 to Good Kid, Mad City to Pimp a Butterfly to Damn to this. He's always had a message. I think the difference with this album is the sound, and as deep as he went. Like that story, what was it called? Duckworth on Damn?
Mm-hmm.
That was heavy. You know what I'm saying? Like, your label boss was about to kill your dad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And somebody of his caliber to be, four or five albums in, and just to tell that story on that album.
Yeah.
And then you listen to this one, and he has more stories about his mother, about cousins, and
his auntie.
His aunties, man. Cancel culture, man. You know he's receiving backlash from the LGBTQ+ community about that song.
No. Why?
You know, in the song, he's like, faggot, 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 we didn't know any better.
Okay.
He
didn't know any better.
Yeah, but there's a lot of gay spokespeople, I guess you would say, that are coming out and saying that we don't need your approval and you should never use that word in that song. And it just made me realize people are stupid. No, I mean, people are stupid. Like, Future's album came out, right?
Yeah.
I couldn't get through the first, I think I got maybe to the third song, not listening to the first two all the way through. I skipped.
Yeah.
Have
you played the rest? Never?
No.
Did you never get to the Drake song, I'm On One? That song is a song right there.
Well, I'm going to have to listen to it, man. But the thing that pisses me off, man, every single thing that Kendrick said in his album is hip-hop right now. What Future is doing in his music. He got all those baby mamas, you know, daddy issues. That's what these niggas have.
Yeah.
And it's this guy, this YouTuber I follow, Sean C. He went through each song and he just was just shitting on it. like shitting on it and shitting on it. He played the Future album and he was like, yeah, this is about, this is what I'm talking about right here. See, album of the year. Well, I don't get it.
It's because this album is for grown people who've been through some shit. It's really one of those types of albums.
Yeah,
if you're a young nigga and you ain't done nothing in life, this shit is not going to connect at all. You ain't going to be able to connect to this.
Mike, you're right.
Yeah.
But every single thing that he's talking about in this album, the fake bravado, having daddy issues, and you got your tattoos and guns to try to cover up shit that happened to you or the things that you've seen or you being bullied or molested or whatever.
Right.
He's talking. Most of these niggas are going through exactly that. And that is the main reason that I feel like people don't like this album. Because it's a mirror.
Yeah.
You know?
They don't want to hear that.
Everybody gangster, nigga? Everybody gangster? Young Thug and his people, Rico charges. He a gangster.
Yeah.
The niggas are so fucking stupid that you think you tight with a guard and he's going to sneak in some shit.
Mm-hmm.
He's crooked guard. No, he was actually working with the police. So they got you on everything. Like wiretap trying to kill niggas. Mm-hmm. And I'm just like, all right, this is my thing, right? Mm-hmm. You a gangster, you a thug.
Right.
But you are complaining about inhumane living conditions in jail. Yeah. But you a gangster though, right? You a thug.
Yeah, man. You should be used to that. You should be accustomed to that hard shit.
Niggas is weird, man. What did you think about the cover when you first saw it?
I didn't really know. I saw that thing, but I didn't know it was going to be his album cover. I don't know. It just seemed like, oh, he got two kids. Okay. I didn't know
when
that.
When I saw that album cover, like the thing that stuck out to me was the crown of thorns and the gun in his belt.
I didn't even know it was no gun.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that. I ain't peeped that.
When I looked at it, I was like, this is about to go crazy, right? Because Charlamagne the guy said there's a thin line between ratchetness and righteousness, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what Kendrick was doing, he was like, y'all, what I got from the cover, right? And I was just talking to my cousin about this. When the song All Right came out, right? When he made that song, he wasn't expecting it to be the song of what we were going through some years later. You know what I'm saying? With the injustices and the police killing black people.
Yeah.
And I think people hold Kendrick to a higher standard than they do other people, right? Other rappers in the game.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that's where the crown of thorns came from. I'm not your savior. Mm-hmm. I'm not your God.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever, right? But then, like he said, y'all want me to be your savior, but he's, I'm a stepper. I'm more like Kodak Black, right? Mm-hmm. Which is where the gun comes from in his belt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you got your two kids on there,
mm-hmm.
which shows that he's a different type of nigga because nobody knew he had kids.
Yeah.
Nobody knew. We knew his girl. He got married, his fiance. He was a pitcher, but nobody knew that shit.
Right.
So, for me, looking at that cover, I knew that the album was going to be something different. A lot of religious people had a problem with it.
Okay.
They called it a blasphemous. He's disrespecting Jesus.
Wow.
And I'm like, so you get all that from a cover art. That he's disrespecting somebody. I'm a Christian. I didn't think he was disrespecting Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
I knew exactly where he was going with that, the crown of thorns, right? But to get into the religious point, it's like he said, I am not your savior.
Mm-hmm.
I might rap and y'all might think I'm your savior, but I'm not.
Right.
And all these religious fanatics are out there like just getting views and just talking bad about an album cover. And I just don't understand why people take things the wrong way.
Wow. I didn't really know there was so much backlash for this, for everything that you're talking about. I didn't know that people didn't fuck with the album. I didn't know there was people objecting about the cover.
Yeah.
I haven't really seen any. I haven't looked for that, honestly. I haven't really looked or cared, I guess, about what other people thought about this album, really.
Right.
Just kind of wanted to have my own opinion, inform it by what I hear. I guess. But where do you rank this album out of his discography?
Oh, man. I would have to say Good Kid, Mad City is number one for me.
Okay.
Number one. I would put this album number two, Damn number three.
Okay. I have Damn at number one for me, and I have this at number two, and I have Good Kid number three. But whatever.
What did you think about To Pimp a Butterfly? I thought that was a really good album. I remember when that album came out, I was in the hospital, and I remember thinking, oh shit, that Kendrick album came out. Had all the shit hooked up to me in my chest and IV in my arm, and I got up, purchased the album, and like listened to it all the way through. Kendrick is different.
Mm-hmm. I can say that from Section 80 to now, like the growth is really like amazing for him. Like he's always been great. He's always been great lyricist. Right. He's always been having great content. But like you can really from where he started to where he is now, man, he's really just went to another level. Like.
And to just not give a fuck about sales,
yeah.
Your album release party, you just go to Africa.
Yeah,
you're in the slums of Ghana just playing soccer with little African kids, and you know what I'm saying? Like that's different, nigga. People, Word. And you know DJ Academics, he, of course, you know he was shitting on him a little bit after the album came out, but he said some shit that I kind of agree with. He said, the things that Kendrick Lamar talks about in his album, Drake could never. He said, Drake come out, talk about a bitch that fucked you up or you fucking bitches and she make you feel some type of way, you shitting on her. That's Drake's bag right there. That is all he can do.
Mm-hmm.
Kendrick Lamar will like change the whole entire culture. The nigga broke Apple Music. He broke Spotify and everybody has been talking about this album. And I thought about this, and people are saying that this is Kendrick Lamar's 444.
Mm.
I get what people are saying,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah. But at the same time, I don't really agree that much. Because 444 was a response album of something that happened in Jay-Z's marriage. And he was kicking mm-hmm. a little knowledge too.
Mm-hmm.
I think this album was a little bit deeper than 444. It wasn't like I cheated on my wife, even though he did address that in his album.
Yeah.
I just think this 444 had layers, but not as many layers as the Big Steppers.
I feel you. Yeah, you're right. He definitely went deeper into a lot of other subject matter. It wasn't just about Please Forgive Me, Beyonce
type of album. Right.
So yeah, you're right. Gave us a lot to think about for sure. Yeah. I understand where they're coming from though.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
Yeah.
That was Jay-Z's most mature album.
Yeah.
This is one of Kendrick's most mature album.
Yeah.
Subject matter deep. I get it.
Yeah.
But I just feel like this has a little bit more layers.
It's crazy that Jay-Z's most mature album comes when he's like 50 years old, though, and Kendrick's like 32.
But you know what, though? Like, Jay-Z, he was always like mature. I think people are looking at him different now is why they think that 444 was so mature. He's a businessman. He's not a rapper. He's meeting with the NFL. He's doing all this shit. Not that law about using rap lyrics, it got passed.
Oh, yeah?
It did.
Really?
So, yeah, it did. Well, so that should help. He's doing.
Damn.
He's doing a lot. And I feel like if you go back to his discography, like, he was always, like, yeah, it was money, selling drugs and stuff like that. But he was throwing little, like, pieces of knowledge in there as well. I think that people took the 444 so much is because of Beyonce.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, like, we discussed this some podcasts ago, him being with Beyonce it got a whole different demographic of fans to actually pay attention to him.
Yeah, definitely.
But one thing I do like similarities between Kendrick and Jay is they're not on social media. Mm-hmm. And if they do a song or album, they're going to address shit that happened a little while ago. Somebody say something about him or whatever. He just going to come out and say some shit 2 years after it happened. Yeah. I think that's pretty cool and pretty funny because most people now, something happened, they got to jump on the internet immediately.
Yeah.
Right. I'm ignorant as fuck. And this shit kind of pissed me off. You know, see the thing is, mm-hmm. The two chicks that was on Joe Budden's podcast. Mm-hmm. The fat one that looked like she smells like salmon. She was really disrespectful.
Okay. What she did?
She, you know what? I'm just gonna play it. Maybe
smells like salmon.
I don't know. Maybe you won't think that it's is disrespectful like I do. But with the things that she talks about,
if I wanted to fucking hear poetry, I would read Dr. Seuss. I don't know. One of these other fucking poetry motherfuckers.
The fact that Dr. Seuss was poetry.
Okay, Maya Angelou, whatever.
There we go.
But okay, you get me. What I got from this album gave me what I feel when I listen to podcasts. It's thought-provoking. It felt like conversation to a beat. It didn't feel like music.
It's like we all been reading Sister Soulja and somebody hands us fucking The Alchemist to read
and absorb it in one take.
I love that Kendrick has
set. Okay. Like the first part, it's like, oh yeah, it was cute. But I wanna play something, right? So you're gonna throw shots at Kendrick Lamar. And I was reading the comments and she was throwing like she was like, I don't give a fuck what Kendrick think of my opinions. Fuck him.
Okay.
And I just want
to read and absorb it in one in The Alchemist to read
So a woman disses an album like this. But this is the things that she says.
We are going to put a little bit of a trigger warning on the top of this episode because we're
the number one thing that
I think we should definitely give a trigger warning for this episode.
Well, I can't find it, but pretty much
this is how I know I'm a criminal. Haven't owned a car in a long time.
She was just talking about
welcome guys to another episode.
How she went to
that'd be sound hard.
You look hella gay. But I love it.
You know what it is? It's the glasses, too.
What the hat?
God damn it. I thought I had it.
Brr, we look like animals.
I'm also matching. You just don't see me.
You're married now. How'd you meet your wife?
Pretty, pretty much.
Is this just, this, what is this?
This is just like the clips of
I wrote
of
this
podcast.
Piece for Bionic Woman.
But pretty much, she...
Do they have a instrumental playing through their whole show? Is that what that is? Or is that just highlights?
It was highlights. You know that shit that everybody was doing, like the females was doing, like I don't even got to walk in with my tool out and they all just like fucking clap their asses. That's what you heard.
Oh, okay.
Very funny.
I can't find
it. Have you used the rose?
She just talks about going to different sex clubs and she just broke up with her significant other.
Sex clubs?
Yeah, she goes to sex clubs.
What is that exactly?
It's just clubs where you go and you have to all day. It's like a underground, like sex dungeon parties, right? So what they do is you have to get an invite. Mm-hmm. Okay. So what they do, they send you an invite and you approve or deny, right? So you have to go before you can participate in the sex party. Mm-hmm. You have to go and get tested for all sexually transmitted diseases, HIV, AIDS, mm-hmm. chlamydia, whatever.
Yeah.
And then you go and you just walk around, pussy out, dick out, and you just fuck.
Okay.
So with her, she goes to sex parties. And she met a guy there and they didn't fuck at the party. They left. Mm. They go to a sex shop.
Okay.
And they purchased toys. Mm-hmm. And purchased the toys that she used on him.
Okay.
And, see, this is my thing with that situation, right? So you have a problem with somebody talking about generational curses and being married and cheating and just everything that you go through, being a parent. But you have a podcast called Horrible Decisions where you talk about all the men that you sleep with, all, you know, the STDs that you have gotten.
Okay.
And you record yourself fucking men with dildos and you play it for everybody there, but you can't appreciate this vulnerable man, this album that is great, that's promoting therapy, mental health for African Americans, but you want to talk, and let's be honest, little girls listen to her.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so yeah. You, this album is not, I don't know, it's not good, but talking about fucking niggas in their ass with dildos is great. Well, that thing pisses me off.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I feel you, but obviously she's telling you that that's not the vibe she's on. She wants to hear ratchet shit. She's about some ratchet shit. So Kendrick talking about all the serious stuff and
trauma. I like my ratchet shit too.
But I mean, I know.
You
I know.
Just can't live on ratchetness alone.
Hey, you're right. You shouldn't, but that's where she's at in her life. But maybe one day she'll get a little deeper and get a little more experience, and maybe she'll mature enough to accept and appreciate it more. But right now, that's not what she's on. Like I said, this isn't for everybody. This is for some people who live some shit and dealt with some shit, and they, you know, can relate. She might be able to relate, but she's not ready to relate to it. So it's not her time.
And it just made me think, I'm going to switch it up for a second. This this shit, Mike, I've been a little depressed lately. Okay. Just depressed about the podcast, right? I'm like, shit is not going the way I thought. You know, I had just big plans and everything, and it kind of slowed up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm looking at some situations. And I'm just seeing random people that don't have any substance to their conversations. Just people are jumping on social media and just saying crazy shit and going viral and getting 10, 15,000 views and getting deals and stuff like that. And you and I don't do. I know I joked with you the other day. Yeah. But it's just like, nigga, like, I feel like we have really great content. Mm. Like, we do. And it's just like, are we going to have to, like, record ourselves getting in a fake fight or some shit, or going out doing dumb shit to go viral? I feel like people that have good content now, they started with the good content. Then they kind of branched off because their views wasn't good, did some viral shit, and then got back to the serious shit. I don't want to do that. But it's just getting to a point now where I'm just like, damn, this shit feels like it's just a waste of fucking time. I'm never going to stop.
Mm-hmm.
But the shit is kind of getting on my fucking nerves a little bit, man. It's like I see motherfuckers not doing anything. They're just getting on there smoking and interviewing women that saying, yeah, I don't want to fuck with a nigga that got a 9-to-5. I need a hustler. I need a drug dealer. Nigga that every day could go out and get killed and won't come home to me. Like, the fuck does that even mean? And these motherfuckers are getting 200,000 views. You know what I'm saying? They're getting deals. They're getting paid. And they're not doing anything. Every podcast out right now is either about sports, sex, horse shit, random dumb shit. Mm-hmm. But I feel like with us, we have a fucking theme, nigga.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We have, hey, this is what we're going to talk about. We pre-plan fucking production text messages. Mm-hmm. And it's just not taking off the way I want it to. Shit's a little demoralized, man. It's like I'm knocked down to the ground.
Things take time, man. And yeah, we can go crazy and do some viral shit, but then we have to always go to the next level. It's not sustainable, the type of shit that happens like that, when you go fucking try to do shit and it's not authentic, man. You gotta just kind of be true to yourself, and it's all gonna come together at the right time. And it's not really like we've been doing so many episodes. We're not even on, like, we haven't even got the 50 episodes yet, man. Shit's extra young. So you just gotta give shit some time to develop and catch on. It's gonna get better, and it's gonna get, you know, more popular. Just be patient. it's hard sometimes when you see people go viral, but it's over some dumb shit, man. And you don't want to be like that, because then that's all. It kind of changes what you are, and you kind of have to be fake. Like, it even happened to Kevin Samuels, man. Have you ever seen some old shit he used to do? He's a whole different guy from what he was like 3 years ago to what he was at the end, man. He's a whole different person because he was kind of leaning into what really worked for him, like what got him the views, and kind of changed his whole persona just to keep the views going. But when he first was out, man, he was a whole different character.
He was. And speaking of Kevin Samuels, people are going kind of crazy.
What you mean?
There's a guy, where he got his money from, I don't know. People say he's a rapper. Mm-hmm. I've never heard any of his music. It's named Bang Man Kevo or some shit. He got a Kevin Samuels tattoo on his thigh.
Like a face?
Like his whole body.
He
Well, I mean, what? Like his bust. Your head to his like torso.
Bust. Funny word.
Yeah, I'm
Kevin
just
Samuels naked. Bust on your face. Who does that? Kevin Samuels bust on your body? Saying that sounds fucking hilarious. You got Kevin Samuels bust on your body?
And
as a man too?
There's been
pause.
Like a lot of videos of people just running out, just jumping out the window with conspiracy theories and everything. And a lady that they're trying to say killed him is saying the next person that puts out a picture of me, I'm suing you. Mm. And I'm just like, where did the foul play shit come from? You know what I'm saying? I'm just like, he was with a chick. He said you could leave. All of a sudden, he has a heart attack. She calls 911. She's crying. She's yelling. And it's foul play, man. Like, she killed that nigga. Like, we got to get that bitch. And I'm just like, I get it. This was y'all's daddy. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But like, people are just coming up with these crazy conspiracy theories. You know what I'm saying? It's like even worse with the whole fucking Tory Lanez and Meg Thee Stallion shit. You know what I'm saying? This shit is crazy. They're like, oh, she was supposed to be a nurse, so she knew what to inject them with. And I'm just like, nigga, what the fuck are you talking about? Was you there?
Yeah, right.
I feel like when you love somebody, like these motherfuckers love their daddy.
Yeah.
I guess they're just like, we have to somehow make him the victim. Like, you talked shit about, and now I'm not shitting on him, right? But I guess they was hurt because he talked so much shit about women.
Yeah.
And they're like, wow, he passed out and fell on top of some woman.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I guess they just, that hurt them or fucked up his legacy or something, I guess. Mm-hmm. I don't know. But
how would you like to die?
I guess in my sleep. Like, I really want to. You know, I've had heart attacks and all this other stuff, and that shit is rough. So I guess I would want to. I don't want to die at all, but if I had to choose, it would probably be in my sleep. Mm. What about you?
Busting a nut. Yeah.
How did I on top of me?
Yeah, that would be the ideal way for me. That would be. I have a question for you. This is random, but what would you do if your girl got an OnlyFans account and you found out about it?
Man, I don't know. I guess I'll be upset.
Mm-hmm.
But if the little skeleton-shaped chick, you know, made $52 million in a year, it's lucrative.
Okay.
Like, you can do some shit. So I guess I would be upset, but there's motherfuckers that was making a shitload of money, like that one chick. Oh my god, what's her name? Farrah, I think she was from Teen Mom or something. Like, okay, she made a shitload of money. I didn't even think she was getting naked on that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? This bitch is just like in bathing suits, like putting fucking body lotion on, like, is making money. So
the Bernie Mac girl is on there. She don't
Camille Winbush.
I ain't no whole nigga. Goddamn.
Yeah, huh?
know her whole name. Remember her?
Because like, damn, nigga. Just because Charlamagne the God, he posted her, and I follow her on Instagram.
Okay, okay.
And she does post pictures. Like, she'd be like ass naked.
First, she was like, "I'm going to be on here. I'm just going to talk about things about females, and you know, I'm not going to get naked and all that." But that shit went out the window.
Yeah, but it's like on Instagram, she posts seductive photos. Like, she'd be like ass naked, but she'd have like one leg over the other, and then her arm covering her boobs. Mm-hmm. And I'm just like, facially wise, I can't say she's ugly.
Nah, she's not ugly. She's just not sexy.
Yeah, but that her skin complexion is beautiful though, and I think that's the thing with her. And
yeah, have you seen Sonic, or Sonic 2? Those movies.
My kids have saw Sonic 1. Okay. I never.
It's a girl. It's the black woman that's like a lead in that movie. She got some. Her complexion is beautiful too. It's just like it's mocha. It's just something about it. It's just kind of like, I don't know. It's beautiful.
Right.
Off topic.
Yeah, man. Women are beautiful. Some more than others.
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. Tory Lanez, he posted a snippet of a new song that he's coming out with tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
He said that I haven't released a real single in like 2 years. He said a lot of y'all niggas blackballed me, but I'm back. So he said he's sending it to like DJs, and I guess this shit is supposed to be played on the radio.
Okay. New shit is coming. Like, really. A lot of new shit is coming.
Yeah, nigga. Lupe.
Yeah, Lupe's coming.
The Game.
Tomorrow, you know the Migos apparently broke up, right? You heard about that?
Yeah, I don't believe that.
Yeah,
I think it's a rollout.
I think it's a rollout, too.
I think it's a rollout.
But they got a new single coming out with the new group, Unk and...
Yeah, with Unk the two Nef, niggas. Yeah.
Whatever it's called. Few and Unk or some shit.
Yeah, the two niggas.
Yeah. Take off him. And not Quavo. Offset?
Yeah. Quavo. No. Wait, which one is married to Cardi B? That's Offset.
I think it's Offset. I think it's Quavo. I think it's Quavo and Takeoff.
Yeah, that's the people that's coming out. Yeah. I don't really know them niggas. But yeah, I mean,
Chris Brown got a new shit coming out, 24th June, I think.
It's a lot of music. But you know what's funny, though?
What's funny?
Kendrick comes out, like, you don't hear shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Once he released, you ain't hear nothing about no releases and all that shit. Now, his shit been out for a week. Now everybody's like, okay, I'm dropping.
Yeah.
They coming. He shut the whole fucking game down.
Niggas is coming, though. Like, okay.
And Lupe. That Lupe shit, that shit sounded good.
Yeah.
That shit sounded good.
Yeah.
So we got Chris Brown, Lupe.
Apparently the game is coming. Yeah.
Drillmatic.
Puffy about to have an album, too, this year.
Ugh.
Ugh. Who else? R&B, rap.
You know what's funny? Speaking about releases, I'm at work. Somebody asked me, hey, did you hear that new Lizzo song?
Lizzo? No.
And I'm like, nigga, do I look like I listen to Lizzo? Like, the fuck kind of question is that?
I never heard a new Lizzo song.
Okay. Yeah, and she is coming out with an album. Got a lot of songs in there. Because after the person said it, I went. And like Lizzo was this thing on her head. She looks fucking crazy. It's a lot of music dropping. I heard some people saying Drake is coming.
Drake. Interesting.
I would say something that I realized from the Kendrick album. Maybe it's just me. He took a couple of shots at Drake.
A couple? I heard a reference, but not even a shot. What did you say?
The shot was Kanye getting back with Drake. I guess whatever he said.
Growing up, their maturity. Yeah. Some shit.
That was a shot at Drake.
You think so?
Yes, 100%. Because I know he fucks with Kanye. He don't fuck with Drake. They had some behind-the-scenes beef for years.
Mm-hmm.
Another one is when he was like, Future is not your savior. And this is not... So he named like people that was hot in the game.
Okay.
He didn't put Drake's name in there. I feel like they have some underhanded shit. And I'm going to find that motherfucking video. There is a video of some guy that works. I don't know if he works there anymore. It was a DJ Vlad interview. And a guy was like, Vlad asked him something about Drake and Kendrick. Mm-hmm. And he never specified which one. He said, Drake or Kendrick, I'm not going to tell you which one, but they came to the studio and they went the hell off. They just was talking big shit about the other person. Mm. So much that we had to scrap the show and they told us that we can't play that tape. Oh. The guy said, if I'm ever down and out and I need some shit, he said, I'm going to steal that tape and I'm going to sell it.
Okay.
He never said who it was, but I know who it was. And I think you know who it was, too. Who do you think it was, Mike? I think it was Drake. I really do. Kendrick is not a person. He doesn't do a lot of interviews. He doesn't go in there, like, talking crazy and shit like that. This whole thing, like, going, talking real crazy about somebody and then having your people saying, yo, don't put that out. Give us the tape. That sound like Drake got on there, got some, you know, little something in him, was talking crazy and got Jay Prince to come up and say, yo, I need that tape. Tell me that don't sound like
that
Drake.
That does sound like Drake. It does. It does sound like a Drake move.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, man. Somebody really need to get Drake, man. I mean, this dude. Pusha got to him, but it was unfinished. I don't think Kendrick's going to do it either, though. Somebody needs to do it, though.
I think if somebody could do it or would do it that he couldn't touch. Now, we already saw Pusha got him and Wayne.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the whole, like, yeah, I have a girlfriend. She just lives in another state shit, you know? Like, mm-hmm. The whole, like, oh, yeah, like, I got a diss track, man. Like, Drake has something. We're not going to get down in the mud like pigs. Like, nigga, shut the motherfucking country.
I would have ended his career with that shit.
Like, nigga, please.
I ain't want to do it to him like that.
The reason that I never believed that story, Pusha T is a different nigga. Mm-hmm. When he went on Joe Budden's podcast with recordings of Drake's people trying to get info on him, nigga, like, what type of nigga does that shit? You bring audio recordings of a nigga that you fucking exposed. You have him, his people calling people that was associated with you to try to get dirt on you. Yeah. And then he was like, yo, if we do this, like, I remember weird shit, I know. If we do this, it's going to be like gunplay. Y'all ready for that type of shit? Like, Pusha's a different type of nigga. Like, I don't know, man.
I wonder what he did to get banned from Canada. What did he do?
Who?
Push.
He's
banned from Canada. He can't go.
Well, we already know why. Who runs Canada, nigga?
Yeah, but what did he do?
He freaking made the Canada King look like fucking shit.
How can Drake do that, man? That's crazy.
Do you know how much money that nigga has?
How can Drake
that's
do that?
See, that's this crazy. But this is the thing,
that
though,
he can
Mike.
Get you banned from a country.
This is the thing, right?
Hove can't get you banned from America
because Hove not on that shit. You know what I'm saying? He has a lot of money. I'm pretty sure that if Jay-Z was on that time, he could do some shit to just have, like, maybe not America, but you ain't coming to Brooklyn. You ain't coming to
okay,
New York.
Okay, blocks or
you're
cities.
Not, yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that's normal.
Yeah, okay. But what I'm saying is, like, people look at Drake. Oh, no, fuck it. It was a poll on YouTube, and it said, is Drake overrated? I put yes.
Mm-hmm. I would put yes, too.
I was part of
6%. Oh, shit. Was it Drake.com?
94% of the people said that he's not overrated.
Underrated, huh? Okay.
Or let rated. Me ask you this, though.
He's rated.
Do you feel like Drake having as much money as he has makes people like him?
Because Drake has money, you said that's why they like him?
Drake has money, and I feel like having money as a rapper right now is more important than actually living what you're rapping about.
I think they like him because he makes, well, they being women, makes a lot of songs that, you know, appeal to females. And that's his demographic.
But I'm going to be honest with you, nigga. When I'm searching through social media and YouTube comments, there's more niggas than bitches defending Drake.
Oh, really?
It's like 90% men.
Really?
Like, yes, it's nothing but, yeah, that nigga got money. Y'all just mad. That nigga is the greatest ever. He's the GOAT. Like, there's nobody better than him.
Okay, well, online, yeah, I guess a lot of niggas is online. But when it comes to purchases, it's the women that's out there at the concerts and purchasing. I would say that's where
I like Drake.
Support is.
I like Drake.
Yeah.
He's okay.
Yeah.
So far going and all that. Mm-hmm. It was cool.
Yeah, you know
what I'm saying? Take Care was good.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But personally, in my opinion, there's never been a Drake album that I listened to that shit and was like, damn, this dick is really saying some shit. And would go back to it again.
True. That's true.
I've never heard a Drake album like that. Maybe the first week of the release, you know, you're like, okay, yeah, that nigga saying shit, okay, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's facts. I don't ever look for Drake when I play music. I don't ever search for Drake.
Yeah.
He just happens to come up, but I don't look for him.
I think the only song of Drake's recently that I've went back to, I guess that really wasn't that recent, was the diss song he did to Meek.
Okay.
Back to back. Yeah. I think that was one song that I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to play this shit. It's not really, everybody's like, this is the best of all time. It was, you get embodied by a singing nigga. That's what it was. It was a soft, fluffy diss track.
It was.
That's all it was. But it was good. Fluffy. It was okay.
Yeah.
But
that song I'm on one with Future and Drake is a banger, though.
It really is.
Yeah, that's a banger. That's a banger.
Okay, let me ask you a question. Do you feel like Drake jumps on trends and fads and does songs with people that he knows up and
definitely
coming so he cannot lose his popularity?
That is definitely a strategy that he takes.
If he didn't do that, would he be as big as he is now? If he didn't jump on shit with Tim's and WizKid and Burna Boy?
I don't think so. I think that it helps him stay relevant. But that is a strategy that has been employed by Hove as well. To stay current, to keep current. He's been with the young niggas from early on in his career. He's done that shit.
Right. I saw a comment. Somebody put, what did they say? Drake is the GOAT. Somebody said, no, Hove is the GOAT. He got a Billy. Somebody said, no, Drake has more money than Hov.
That's not true.
Drake has more money than Hov.
Nah.
How could a person even say that?
I don't know.
I don't understand. There's a thing called fandom and, you know, you're a fanatic and all that. But let's be honest. The Kendrick album, we're both fans of Kendrick.
Uh-huh.
There are maybe one or two songs that I'm just like, I get the message, but it's too, I can't do it, right? So you can be a fan, but then say, yo, I don't like this.
Yeah.
These fans now, it's like, everything's perfect.
Yeah, that's not right, man. You got to have some kind of...
Everything's perfect. Like, what are you talking about? You're a hater. Like, If it's not good, it's not good.
Yeah, man.
But I'm at the age now where people's opinions kind of irritate me. You know what I'm saying? I know that sounds crazy, but it's just like, you can't. There are some Future songs that I like that are very catchy that I like. But to just sit there and listen to Future. Like, I'm at an age now where I need some substance. You know, if I have an hour, 2 hour ride home sometimes, especially on Fridays, if I'm in a good mood, it's sunny outside, I might put on some shit, got a little bop to it, and I can jam in the car, right? Mm-hmm. But then sometimes I'm like, yo, it's going to be a long ride home. My job pissed me the fuck off. I need some lyrical shit that's going to make me think. Just the whole party shit all the time is just not cool. Even the whole lyrical shit all the time. Mm-hmm. And I feel like nowadays it's just cool to hate on something that other people like.
Yeah.
If it's your real opinion, that's fine. But like, I feel like, okay, for instance, title the podcast is about Kendrick. The album comes out. Some people said they got it at midnight. Some people say they couldn't get it out until 2, mm-hmm. right? We talked about this on Instant Classic. Instant Classic Part 2. The album released at midnight. There's really not a lot of albums that's 15 minutes long.
Yeah, and this is like a double 12:15,
12:30, you're talking about, yo, like, this is classic. This is the best shit I ever heard, or this is ass. Like, what the fuck was he thinking?
Yeah.
Like, that's what I'm saying. It's like a microwavable society. When our Future album came out, there were fucking videos and videos and videos of people just breaking down the album. I'm like, okay, that makes sense. It's no substance, so you can break it down, you know what I'm saying, doing perks, lean, and fucking bitches.
Yeah,
like,
pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah.
But it's just like, yo, like, you're just going to, like, break down the whole album, like, 10 minutes after it came out? Yeah. I don't get it. Like, you and I are breaking down and talking about an album, the layers to it, like almost a week after it came out. So we had time to sit and process the situation and process what he was talking about. But DJ Academics, he was kind of going in, you know, like, I didn't watch it because when he gets on his little Henny rant, sometimes he's just unbearable. Henny rants,
yeah.
But he said the title of the video was DJ Academics Goes Off on Kendrick for Going at Drake for Making Up with Kanye.
Mm. Okay.
Like, I considered it a little shot. I did. But was it something where it can cause an uproar in the hip-hop community? I don't think so.
Nah.
I know with DJ Academics, with his group, his fan base, they can make a mountain out of a molehill with certain situations.
True.
But I feel that this album has been everything that people were dealing with for years, their entire lives. He covered pretty much everything that have been happening in the last, since Damn came out, actually.
Right.
I feel like it was a really great album. You have to sit with it. The first listen, like, you're like, wow, okay, it's heavy.
Mm-hmm.
But then, like, it sounded different my second time. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm even talking musically. Yeah. Like music, like with the instruments. It was like some of the beats and everything. When I'm listening to it now, I'm like, oh damn, it didn't sound like this the first time. Mm-hmm. I guess because I really wasn't focused.
You're
on
listening
it.
To words, yeah.
But yeah, man. Overall, really, really great album. You can go back to this 10 years from now and still be like, yo, this is some heavy shit. But Joe Budden said it on his podcast. He said, y'all think that the distance between this and Damn was long. He said, this nigga gave us a double album, so we ain't hearing from this nigga no time soon.
Could be. Or it could be like a Nas situation where he's just really ready to just give shit out, like, all the time.
Especially on his own shit.
Yeah, he might be just
PG
ready.
PG Lang.
He might just have shit in the chamber just ready.
That N95 video.
Uh-huh.
Like, N95, I didn't really like it at first. Uh-huh. It had to grow on me a little bit. But then I listened to, like, the messenger and what he was actually saying, what he meant.
Take it off.
It was, I was like, wow, okay. Video was very creative. I think his next single should be, what's the name of that damn song? I think it should be Savior. Die Hard or Purple Hearts.
I feel like it could be. I hope it's Silent Hill or Mr. Morale. I want those to be the next
one. Speaking of that, Nigga. And I'm not just saying this because he was on the Kendrick album, but
Kodak.
Like,
yeah.
It made a lot of sense what he was, why he was on this album. Uh-huh. Because most people think Kodak is just this drugged up, ignorant, dumb nigga from South Florida.
Right.
But he held his own on some of those tracks. He really did. Yeah. The interludes, yeah, the things he was saying.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, for a person like Kendrick to give you your flowers and have you on an album like, mm-hmm, this means a lot. So yeah. I think Kodak is about to take the fuck off.
That's
now.
A great look for him. Definitely.
Because people that don't listen to Kodak is going to start listening. I mean, I remember I sent you, it was a couple months ago, I sent you a song. It was a Kodak song. Mm-hmm. You're like, nigga, what? What is this? I listened to it and I'm like, he was saying some shit. I think sometimes with me, I feel like I'm just such a music head that it's just like, if a person, their vibe is off to me, I won't listen to their music. But the song was good. He was very, he talked about the shit that he went through, and mm-hmm, he's been through some shit. Mm-hmm. I mean, just recently got shot. Mm-hmm. But I'm glad he was on this album. Overall, very, 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 very good album.
Yep.
Hopefully, it won't be another 5 years.
I don't think so.
Nas, speaking of new music dropping, I heard Nas is coming out with another joint.
Yeah.
Hit Boy said, we got another one dropping.
Yeah, yeah. That was a little while ago. So
Magic.
Soon.
Magic was good. Mm-hmm. Some people shit on it, but I guess that's what people do. Right. But it was good. Mm-hmm. And the thing that is surprising with Nas, like, yeah, like you said with Kendrick, like, damn, like, in this short career, mm-hmm, you know, he's getting better and better. Nigga, mm-hmm, Nas has been rapping since I was a kid.
Yeah.
And he's still sharp.
Still sharp as hell.
That is different.
Yeah, man.
Like, that is different.
Yeah.
But one album that, and we can play out sleepers. One album that I just recently went back to was the Lloyd Banks joint.
Which one?
What's the name of that shit? The one he just released not too long ago. Oh my god, man. Where's this shit at? That was a really good album too. The Course of the Inevitable.
Oh yeah,
that was really good.
Yeah. That was
that should have gotten a little bit more respect than it did. But he's now, I guess, the Rotten Apple or the Hunger for More. I forgot which one it was. Those were his like album because he was on G-Unit.
Yeah,
it was
big,
commercial.
Yeah, you don't have that big push no more.
Yeah. Oh, and speaking of more music, Rhapsody. I don't know if you fuck with Rhapsody, but she's dropping a fucking album. She said it's done. The album is done. Like Kendrick and fucking Rhapsody, nigga. I'm ready. But
But have you heard that? What was her name? Sabrina Claudio. Have you heard her album? The new joint is hard.
Nigga. Yes. I've been listening to her for some years, nigga.
Yo.
I love that album. Her voice really is good. Her voice is Lord have mercy.
Yeah, man. Fuck with that album.
Yeah, it's really good.
My sleeper's changing, by the way.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with the future Drake I'm on one song. Since we've talked about it like five times, I feel like that I teased it enough. We gotta play it now for the people. And you too. You ain't heard it.
Right. Okay.
It's a banger.
And what's the name of it again?
I'm on one. Don't expect any substantive shit to be talked about, okay? This is a good ass song.
Yeah, any song with Future is not gonna have shit in it.
I don't even particularly like Drake too much on this song, but this song is, if you just wanna, you know, this is a good summer song. I fuck with it. Future. I know, man. You talk about shit you don't do, you a bad influence. But I like this song.
All right, man. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is I'm On One. This is Future featuring Drake.
Lego.
Hold up. Wait. It's that
so gas. I know what to do with it.
And that gas. That global high. Yeah.
about a murder case. Telling on yourself, there's only way you wanna escape. Call me Michael Phelps from swimming in your bitch face. Pop a Adderall so I can focus, count his cake. Skinny nigga, but my pocket's out of shape. ATL nigga, all the cars, California plates. Five for my niggas, they gon' get it crackin'. Four trade gangsters, they gon' get it crackin'. ABK gon' walk a nigga down straight jacket. Niggas gon' psychotic, back this shit, ain't this rappin'. Niggas pullin' robberies in this bitch, we ain't just trappin'. If another body try to fizz, might just snatch me. Man down, I'll be overseas when it happen. Word around town, got them peas in the attic. I'm applying pressure in the field, John Madden. 100,000 vacuum sealed up, I'm just stacking. Vanessa knows a sport, caught me a yellow one like Fabulous. 425, two stone, check the carry. I'm on one, I'm on one, yeah.
She wanna see the world and she tired of sitting still. I'ma take her ass to Paris, fuck her on that Ferris wheel. Take her to see Cristiano, fuck her in that Benz Viano. Champions League shit, there'll be a driver for you on arrival. When I finally see you, all I wanna see is right hand, right knee, left hand, left knee. Made that ass wave, made that ass jet ski. What? I don't know why the fuck niggas tryna test me. What? I'm just all about my goals like a vet ski. What? I'm just all about my goals like I'm messy. What? Being messy, shit do not impress me. What? I could never be a man, I'm your bestie. What? And I never liked you niggas, so don't text me.
I'm on one, I'm on one.
Okay, okay.
Outside my body, I'm on one.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was I'm On One, Future featuring Drake. My sleeper is Ron Obasi, Diss a Layup.
All right. Diss a Layup.
Diss a Layup. Diss a Layup. Trap back, booming, it's a vibe, babe. Don't decline. Yeah. I said the trap back booming, it's a vibe, ay. Don't decline, ay. Ain't a better fucking drug that get you high, say. Classifying, magnified grace, this shit divine, ay. Ain't a better fucking thing that's advertised, ay. The mastermind, ay. This a layup, this a layup. Check it out, check it out. Patience is virtue, yeah, I know that bitch by first name. She gave me my first game, converted to sermons. Word so cold, word to Jermaine. But I'm too clear, I need a campaign. I need a parade, the niggas and folks. Who would lay ho if you can't? Shit. Ho if you can't, ho if you vividly destined, what is my air? This shit is infectious, feeling so festive. These niggas extra, these niggas question. Quick as they come, quick as they exit. I pick up the phone, read the message. Do it big, baby, from a shot. It coming straight from Texas. Oh, that's bigger, right? Cosmos in the block. Love me, nigga, that's a different high zone. And then I'm on different time, shit. I set the trap back, booming, it's a vibe, ay. Don't decline, ay. Ain't a better fucking drug that get you high, say. Classifying, magnified grace. This shit divine, hey. Ain't a better fucking thing that's advertised, hey. The mastermind, hey. This a layup, this a layup, this a layup. Ain't a better fucking thing that's advertised.
talking too proper, huh? Never shaky on the approaches. Niggas be Harlem, huh? Getting ahead of life, getting head from life. She make it sloppy, brains are flawless, big as my conscience, let's be honest, you can line 100,000 niggas up, still be the option. You can line 100,000 niggas up, still be the option, I set the trap back, booming this survive, ay, don't decline, ay, ain't a better fucking drug that get you high, say, classifier, ay, magnify, grace this shit divine, ay, ain't a better fucking thing that's advertised, ay, mastermind, ay, this a layup, this a layup, classifier,
magnify. Alright, ladies and gentlemen,
yo, we're not quite.
Oh, we're not done yet?
We didn't talk about a specific thing we were supposed to talk about with a trial that's been going on.
Oh, yeah. Johnny Depp. Amber Heard.
You heard.
All I'm going to say is this. If Johnny Depp loses this case, it's over.
There's no way. There's no way he's going to lose the case because
she lied about everything.
Yeah, but do you even see her lawyers are like giving up on her too?
And she's like, I'm trying, Your Honor. I'm trying. Like, if you know that you couldn't get one question out,
did she get public defenders?
Nigga, it's a black guy from Atlanta. I think his YouTube is the head attorney.
I heard about him.
Shit.
I just saw him yesterday, actually, yeah. For the first time.
And he's saying that Amber Heard is paying them motherfuckers
$6
million.
$6 million?
$6 million. I could defend her better than that.
They are terrible. They're not even prepared for anything. And everything they say is an objection.
And the crazy thing, like the judge is getting mad too. The judge is like, the objection is sustained. Next question. But Your Honor, next question. I'm like, yo, like, what is going on?
I can't understand. How are you so rich, but you have the worst defenders?
You know what? I think it gets to a point where she knows that she lied.
Mm-hmm.
And I just like, you know what? She's like, whatever. The thing that stuck out to me, like she can't act. She was fake crying, right?
Mm-hmm.
But Johnny Depp's lawyer, Camille? Yes. but the crazy thing, like she bought up. All right. See if you, because we was watching it that day. Mm-hmm. You remember when she was like, Camille put up the pictures, and she's like, you just really like taking pictures of Mr. Depp, didn't you? Now, he had his hands in his pants, right? Mm-hmm. Or in his pocket.
Mm-hmm.
And then one hand was like right here, and he had ice cream, and it flipped over when he fell asleep. Now, when that happened, you remember Johnny whispered something in the lawyer's ears, wrote something down, and gave it to her. Now, this is what I want to know.
Okay.
Who eats ice cream with a hand in her pocket and eating with the other hand? That photo was staged. The cocaine photos and stuff like that, I think a lot of those were staged. Mm. Now, Johnny Depp, coke, drugged out, that's what he does.
Yeah, he admits to that.
Yeah, but a lot of those photos were staged. I don't think he was high and fucked up in most of those photos. I think sometimes, like, he just like, yo, like, it's the bender, we're fucked up or whatever. I'm just going to lay here on the hotel floor and go to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And I really think that she just was like, she married the nigga for money. Mm-hmm. And she was trying to ruin him because he would not put up with her shit.
Yeah.
And I think she tried to ruin him. But, you know, they had 4 million signatures. It was down to 10 minutes in Aquaman 2. The last thing I read was she's totally removed from the movie.
Oh,
completely.
Wow.
And whatever deal she had with Marvel or DC, whatever it was, I think Marvel, like, she's done. The contract is void.
Wow.
Now, I don't think this trial, the only thing that this trial did for Johnny is so that he's not abusive and this is all her.
Yeah.
But I don't. It's not looking good for him either. Like,
you don't think so?
No, what I mean is not looking good for him, like, for him to get any movie roles and shit.
Why?
Like, just like
his name is clear. Like,
okay,
he's out here getting.
You know, no, you're right. But it's just like, all right, in the court of public opinion, like, he's the champ, he won.
Yeah.
We all love him and everything, right? But I feel like he's a damaged person. I feel like if our people, and I don't think he's like this anymore, because most of those recordings were from like 4 or 5 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like if these studios did get him to come into the movies, I think they would probably have to get him some therapy or something like that, because these are really damaging tapes that he really has some deep, dark issues. Yeah. And I feel like true. That's another thing. She's like, even though her sister got up there and testified that they all did drugs together,
mm-hmm.
but I think people believe Johnny Depp, always believe Johnny Depp.
Mm-hmm.
People that believe Amber Heard, they believe Amber Heard.
Mm-hmm.
I think if anybody did switch, it's people that believe Amber Heard probably jumped over to Johnny's side.
Yeah.
But for the most part, she's looking really, really bad. And I think that Johnny Depp is being exposed for some of the things, not being abusive, but just how damaged of a human being he is.
I'm not surprised about any of that stuff that they show.
Me either.
Like, it makes sense to me. He kind of seems like the type of person that would be on that type of stuff.
Really. Yeah, just from the movie roles, the Rum Diaries, the Planet, Lord have mercy, Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah.
You know, Edward Scissorhands and 21 Jump Street. Like, he's running some really dark movies.
Yeah.
So, and he's rich.
Mm-hmm.
Filthy rich. So, mm-hmm. coke and whatever is thing. And, mm-hmm. okay, I know I'm talking too much, but the thing that really fucked me up with Amber... Okay, he does drugs.
Mm-hmm.
You did drugs too.
Yeah.
I think the thing that's hurting her is weird to me is I can't remember anything that makes me look bad.
Yeah, everything, like, I don't remember.
Every single thing that somebody else did bad,
details
I can remember.
Yeah.
The carpet dirty, my face was on the window, I was fogging up the glass.
Yeah, yeah.
And
it's very detailed.
Like, that is weird to me. And then this thing right here, right? Mm-hmm. The jury.
Yes. Correct. Yes, he did do that. Uh-huh. Yes, he quickly. Did. Yes.
Yep, quick. Uh-huh. Like, yes. quick.
Like,
no thinking about it. Like, oh, yeah, it was this. It was June 16th.
I'm scared. She is crazy.
She has to be.
Crazy.
She is. 100%. But I think that's what the allure of her to him. It's, he's probably got, you know, he got issues. So that kind of probably attracted him to her.
You know what, though?
Her damaged
persona. But this is the thing, though, right? The last, I think it was an hour or two before you got over here, mm-hmm. I was watching some shit. And her lawyers were trying to make it seem like her trajectory was on, like, her shit was, like, on the way up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be honest with you. Like, I've seen her, but let's be honest. Nobody really knew her until Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
Aquaman, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Who got her that role? No, ma'am, I got it. That's how that worked. I auditioned.
No.
You might have auditioned, but Johnny got you that role. Jason Momoa, the dude that... took my woman, man, Lisa Bonet. He was up there and he unfollowed. Yeah, she is. And her daughter. Wow. He unfollowed Amber and started following Johnny, and it's really on Johnny's side. I feel like it's the year of the men, man. Because Johnny Depp, Tory Lanez, like two guys that were just like everybody hated, they're abusers. You beat a woman. You shot a woman. And it's coming out that the two most important cases that are going around as far as celebrities are concerned are two women that have blatantly lied on two men that were canceled. They saying Johnny lost over $50 million.
Yeah.
Tory, probably more than that because he's in music. But slowly but surely, they're getting their fans back, and people are realizing that these women are lying.
Yeah.
But Meg's still doing it, though. She just won, like, Artist of the Year or some shit.
Artist of the Year?
I don't know if it was Artist of the Year, but now she just won some awards at the Billboard Music Awards.
For what?
I don't know. She just won some awards.
How's she the artist of...
Nigga, I'm just saying, I don't know if it was Artist of the Year album. It was, she won some award. They was talking about it on the Joe Budden podcast.
Artist of the
like,
Year?
She got up there, she got some award, and she did that little Plan B song. I'm a hater, I guess. I really don't like her.
I'm just trying to figure out how she went Artist of the Year doing what?
Maybe I was wrong. I don't think it was Artist of the Year, but my thing is she won something. I don't know if it was like Best Rap Album at the Billboard Awards or something. She won something. And I'm just like,
Best Rap Album?
It was something. I mean, what is she going to get? Like Best, I mean, if it was Twerking Awards, yeah, she would win
Twerking
gold.
Awards, yeah, I can
but it's just like, what album? Like, what that. Other, like, what, Best R&B? It would have to
when
be
her
hip-hop
album, come
album
out?
Or something like that. Nigga, I don't know.
She had an album this year?
I think she did. It wasn't that? Oh, damn. That was when she first got shot, right?
That was not this year.
It wasn't? She released something this year, didn't she?
Some songs?
Well, look, all I know is she got an award.
Okay. That's some sympathy award, then.
It's all been sympathy award because, all right, I really didn't follow her career like that, But she wasn't getting awards like this, though. She wasn't. But when she came out, Tory Shot Me. Mm-hmm. Tory Shot Me. She got awards out the ass.
I have to know what she won, man. I'm going to Google this. What the hell did she win? Meg Thee Stallion. Meg Thee Stallion. So two E's. Double E.
RJ? Come here, bro.
Award. 2022.
Right. So she won what?
Top rap female of 2022.
Yeah, so I know she won something.
But for what?
But let me ask you a question. How can you win awards? I think she had, what, Plan B? And what songs has she put out to win that?
Billboard Music Awards top rap female? Who is in the categories? I really want to know who she beat.
And I feel like we all been working so hard all year. We've been working hard for a long time. And it's just so nice to be appreciated,
very confused.
Recognized, you know, by your peers and celebrated by your peers.
Well, there's
what
really,
did she do?
I mean, this year? Okay, but think about it, though.
What?
Like, she won because she's been in the news the most, but there's really not been no real female putting no shit out. Cardi B, she ain't put no shit out.
That's
Nicki Minaj really ain't put no shit out. She's been featured on songs and stuff like that, but those songs literally just came out.
I have to know who she beat. Best rap female.
Nominees. And the nominees are Meg Thee Stallion, Meg Thee Stallion, Meg Thee Stallion, and Meg Thee Stallion.
She won by default. Okay. No, that can't be it.
I'm just trying to figure out who the fuck else would be in there, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm telling. Nominees.
It couldn't be nobody in there. Because Doja Cat should have won, but they had Doja Cat in R&B and not rap and hip-hop.
That ain't fair.
Because Doja Cat's been taking over.
Man, this is hard to do. Three cheers for Megan Thee Stallion. The Plan B rapper won the 2022 Billboard Music Award for the Best Rap Female category. Who did she beat? Can you tell me? Can you tell me? Can you please tell me? It's like a recap. I don't want to hear acceptance. But I want to hear the nominees are. Who she beat? Blah, 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 blah. Mary J. Blige, Doja Cat. Okay, makes performance numerous celebrities. Performs. I just got.
The only thing I say, with the top female rap artist award, Meg beat out her WAP co-star Cardi B and Latto, among others.
Oh, Mulatto. She had an album out. That's true.
Mulatto, yeah, but she too new to get that shit. Cardi B really hasn't really put out. But didn't Cardi B put out an album after the whole diss track album when she got shot? Because that was Meg's last album, right? I'm just mad they put. If they put Latto and Cardi B, then she couldn't have beat out anybody else like that.
If that was the competition,
they among others, like they're not really naming anything. Damn, I clicked on it. These motherfuckers talking about her getting shot. Oh,
you got it,
nigga. Yeah, all it was Cardi B, Meg Thee Stallion, and Latto. That was it.
Okay,
that was it.
I can okay.
So that makes sense.
Yeah.
I
guess so. She
Latto's album wasn't bad though.
Yeah, so I'm trying. Which song did she win the award for? Meg Thee Stallion. What did she win it for? Was it for Plan B? The song that just came out?
I wouldn't think so.
I don't think that would even qualify.
I don't even think it's a song. It's just female rap artist. That was it. It didn't say like top female rap artist song. It just said
it's Billboard rap artist. It's Billboard, so it's based on like a sale of a song. Right?
I don't know. Who the fuck is Olivia Rodrigo? She beat out Taylor Swift, Doja Cat, and Adele.
That sounds familiar, but I'm not exactly sure who that is.
Maybe my, I think my girls are probably out.
Let me pull up Spotify while you do that. Her top song is Good For You. 1.4 million. 1.4 billion. Good grief. Man, she got a lot of plays.
Yeah, so my girls know who she is.
Whoever she is, she got 1.4 billion views plays. Yeah, for this
they
song.
Said she's on like my daughter said that Olivia Rodrigo is popular. She's on like commercials and shit.
She got two songs on Spotify that got 1.4 billion plays.
Billion?
Billion. 1.4 billion.
I don't understand how a person can get that many views and not, we've never heard of it.
1.4 billion.
That's crazy.
Two songs. I won two songs. That got 1.4 billion. The rest of them almost at a billion.
Well, she's a little cutie pie. Let's see. I'm going to play some of her shit real quick. This song was released 6 months ago and it has 62 million views.
Okay, what's it called?
It's called Traitor.
Oh, yeah, I see that. Okay, on Spotify, it's at 778 million.
Jesus.
Guilty eyes and little white lies, yeah.
Never heard of it, though. But
I always knew that you talked to her, maybe did even worse. I kept quiet so I could keep you. And ain't it funny how you ran to her the second that we called it quits?
Not bad. Sound like some emo shit.
Yeah.
Not bad, though.
How have I never heard anything from her before?
Not bad.
She got a good voice.
Yeah.
Okay. Sour. That's her last album, I guess. Okay. Well, congratulations, Meg Thee Stallion, on your new Best Rap Artist of 2022 award for, I guess, whatever you've done. Song? What? I still don't know what she won it for.
We know what she won it for because she said she got shot.
But that's not a way to win a best rap artist award because you got shot.
Nigga.
What the hell did she drop?
Once again, what was she winning before she came out and said she got shot? Did she have a little buzz? She had the joint with Beyonce, you know what I'm saying? Did she have a song with Nicki? That she had big. A song with Cardi.
That Beyonce look was a big one.
Yes.
It was.
But it was a rumor that was going around that Beyonce didn't want the song to come out. She really didn't do it. But I guess, you know, Roc Nation, that's her husband, and she did it, but she didn't want the song to come out.
So you won a Grammy for Best New Artist in 2021?
Yeah, man. And she got shot in 2020, right?
She won People's Choice Award for WAP.
Oh, man.
She won a Grammy for Best Rap Performance for Savage Remix.
Do you ever think that her videos that she puts on Instagram. She's in the club twerking. Is that ever going to get played out? Because, like, I know twerking went out like a little while ago, but I feel like she's making it come back again.
You think she revived twerking?
I really do. Because, okay. That's all she does. She puts, she might release a snippet of her putting on makeup or, in a studio or something. But other than that, that's all she does is just, she twerks. That's it. Doesn't irritate you a little bit? Like, I know you're single, you love women and
twerking. I don't really see her like that. So it don't bother me because I don't see her.
Nigga.
I don't look at her.
I'm going to tell you this, nigga. Like I said, my job, all I do is I scroll through social media. And that's how I know about the people saying Kendrick with the slurs and all that other shit and the shit that I know and the shit that I text you. Matter of fact, did you get that last video I sent you?
I did receive it, but I did not play it.
Nigga, it is a video. And this dude, like, I listened to him. Like, RJ put me on this
heroin
dude.
Addict, right?
Yeah, RJ put me on this dude, man. It's a video of him taking heroin.
Oh.
He's not a heroin addict. He was doing I guess he has a family member or something that was doing it. He's releasing a product, a project about addiction. And he, in the video, he injected himself with heroin. He recorded, like, the effects of him being high.
What?
Nigga.
How many views is that guy?
I don't know. It's not that many for what he put his body through. I know that.
What would be enough?
I would say it would have to crack at least 100 million.
100 million?
I'm not saying it's worth it, but people crack 100 million doing work, million. Other
only,
shit than that.
He only got 97,000 views.
For see? Shooting and his music is good, though. RJ. Bishop Nehru, you put me on him, right? Did you see that video when he injected himself with heroin?
What, a Trump hoodie? Trying heroin like he never tried it before.
It looks like he's a professional, but you can find how to do shit on YouTube, though, I guess, right?
What is going on here? Oh, no. What? This is crazy. The things you see online now, man. Man, did you see the Buffalo, New York shooter's video of him shooting everybody?
No, I don't want to watch that shit.
That is rough.
Nah.
Rough.
Mm-mm.
I wouldn't. I wish I didn't see it.
Couldn't do it.
I wish I never saw it, man. It came to me, and I saw it, and it was not what I, man.
Wow. I have this thing. I was talking to somebody about it, and I said, people was posting what he was putting on social media and stuff like that. He said, he said, death to drug dealers and all these other people, right? But have you noticed that with these certain, people, they go to innocent people. If you're racist, you don't like black people, I get it. Mm-hmm. But if you specifically said death to drug dealers and gangbangers, drive to the hood and start shooting. I think they don't do that is because they know that they're not going to
low risk,
make
yeah.
it back
yeah.
alive.
Yeah, it's a low
you're
risk.
Going in, you're going somewhere, you're shooting people that are probably not carrying, probably not doing anything in a way that the world is.
Right.
You do this, Fox News is going to big you up. They're going to get a GoFundMe. They're going to pay your bond and all that because he pled not guilty.
Of course.
Killing 10 people?
How could you? How could
how is that not guilty?
Exactly. How could that?
And you recorded yourself doing that?
Yeah, everything's
not guilty due to you insanity, mental defect, something maybe.
Wrote a manifesto. What you gonna do?
And I think his defense, if he's saying not guilty due to mental incompetence or whatever. So you're shooting people. You go to the white dude. Mm-hmm. You're about to shoot him.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry, you walk away.
Yeah.
That shows right there that you have a mind, that you're not crazy,
yeah,
and it was racially motivated.
Exactly.
I'm not going to lie to you, bro. My mom said, I need you to go to the store with me. Mm-hmm. I had my Glock, my 19 right on my side. My wife was like, hey, let's go to the store real quick. Let's go out to eat. I had my Glock on my side. Mm-hmm. My cousin was like, hey, nigga, let's go to the movies. I had my gun on my side. Like, I'm paranoid, nigga. Like, this shit is crazy. And now, what I'm not saying is somebody comes and shoot, I'm like, oh, fuck that shit. Pop, pop, pop. No, I'm not going to do that. Mm-hmm. But I feel like if I have my firearm with me, at least I know I can duck and, you know, at least get off some shots if he does come my way. If he's shooting everybody else, God be with y'all, and I'm running the opposite way. But I have to have my shit with me everywhere I go now. Like, I've always, you know, had my little concealed and my firearm and stuff like that, but you just never know. Like, I think the only joint in Virginia was like, what was it, VCU?
Oh, yeah.
Something with the Asian dude?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But that's a really, really sad thing, man. Those people are gone just because somebody didn't like your skin color, but his family's coming out and saying that it was because of COVID. It was another article I read that's saying that he stabbed a cat and then beheaded the cat.
What?
If you hurt an animal, like, I've watched Criminal Minds and all that shit, they say if you hurt animals and stuff like mm-hmm. that, then you're going to be a serial killer. You're going to be crazy. You don't, like, what do you teach your kids? Like, what do you say to your children when you're just flipping through the channel, or they're playing fucking Minecraft and the ad pops up with the white guy that looks all crazy and demonic eyes, and or the video pops up. Kim Kardashian's sex tape pop up when her son was playing Roblox. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Kids playing Minecraft and that video just happens to play in the background. It just pops up. Like, you can't explain that shit to your kids. Like, there's no way possible that you can just like, hey, there are certain people that are just not going to like you because of the way you look. I've said that to my son before. Mm-hmm. He's 13, going to high school next year. I said, people are not going to like you because of the way you look. What do you mean because of the way I look? You're black. You go to school, you're going to have some teachers that are going to look at you and just throw your papers, your work away, just ball it up, throw in the trash and say that you didn't turn it in just because of the way you look. You can't explain shit like that to your kids, because kids are like, why?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Why? Mm-hmm. There is no why. That's just the way it is.
Mm-hmm.
But really fucked up. And I think the day after that, there was a shooting in California, and then I think the day after that, there was another shooting. So I think it was like, I don't think the people were killed. I think they were just injured, but it was three shootings in a row.
Yeah, just back to back to back. It was crazy.
Like, crazy.
It seemed kind of connected, but
shit's crazy.
That's how it goes though with those mass shootings. It's always like a copycat. It just kind of, it doesn't end with the first one. There's always a few more afterwards. It's always like
that. You ain't get you one yet?
Nah. I want one, but
you need to get one, man. Cause shit is crazy. The only thing you gotta do, well, you know, Virginia's open carry. Mm-hmm. So you gotta do just go in there. It takes a good, depending on where you go. I think my first gun I bought, it took about a good 45 minutes for them to do the background check and all that other shit.
Mm-hmm.
It was like that.